There are probably a million and one things your Mac can do, so these are just 10 cool Mac tips and tricks. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today, I'm sharing some Mac tips that will hopefully make your life a little easier. So let's go. Tip number one, picture in picture. This is really helpful if you're working on something but need to be watching a video at the same time. Now, this sounds counterintuitive, but it's not, I promise. Like, sometimes I'm reviewing videos and taking notes simultaneously, so this is really helpful, especially if you don't have multiple screens. For this trick, we're going to utilize Safari. So, when you're playing a YouTube video in Safari, you should notice a little sound icon, it's like a speaker, in the top right of the address bar, or the top right of the tab if you have multiple tabs open. All you have to do is right-click on that speaker icon and then select Enter Picture in Picture. Your YouTube video will pop out and then you can just click and drag that to where you want it on the screen. So if you're working in Google Docs or Word or something, you can just drag that video right over top and it's going to continue playing while you work, all on the same screen. You can resize it as well, and then you can even pop the video back to the original YouTube player if you want with just a click. Picture in picture for the win. Mac tip number two, AirDrop. This is a great handy tip if you're someone who's just getting your feet wet in the Apple ecosystem. So this is how you transfer photos and videos from iPhone to Mac and vice versa. So first, to do this, you're gonna open up Finder, and then click on AirDrop. Now you may not see anything at first, so all you have to do is unlock your phone, and just like that, your iPhone should appear here. And if for some reason your iPhone is not appearing, just make sure that your devices are on the same Wi-Fi network. Or you can adjust your discovery settings as well. So once your device appears, you can open another Finder window and select the files you want to add to your iPhone, and then you're going to drag and drop them over this iPhone icon, and then those will instantly be copied over to your iPhone. And of course, the reverse can be done here as well. So from the iPhone, you're just going to select the images or videos that you want to share, and then tap on the share button. And then here, select your Mac from this share list. Your AirDrop option should be the first one that appears on the list. So once all these files are transferred, they're going to be added to your downloads folder on your Mac where you can move them as you wish. This works across devices, by the way, so you could do the same thing with your iPad, for example. All right, Mac tip number three, live text. Yes, the same thing you can do with iPhone and iPad, you can do on Mac as well. And this allows you to copy text out of an image. So let's say you have an image on your Mac that you want to copy the text out from. Well, all you have to do is move your cursor over the text, and it changes the pointer to a text selector tool. All you have to do from there is select the text and hit Command C to copy it, or you could right click to copy, and then you can Command V it or right click to paste that text wherever you need it. But that's not all you can do with live text on Mac. Oh no. If your image happens to have a phone number or something like that in it, that's gonna automatically be recognized as such, and you're gonna notice a little box around the phone number and a downward facing arrow to the right of the number. So if you click on that arrow, you're gonna have the option to add that number to your contacts or call, FaceTime, message that number directly. How neat is that? All right, Mac tip number four is to quickly access your emoji keyboard. And yes, this is something I use every single day without fail. Don't judge me. It's probably my most used keyboard shortcut. What can I say? I love me some emoji. So when you're ready to insert emoji into your note or email, just hit Control Command Space to bring up your emoji picker. You could also hit Command Control Space, and it really doesn't matter the order there as long as you hit all three together. And then all you have to do is pick your desired emoji to spice up your note. Now I will say, this used to work totally fine for me in Google Docs, and then it no longer does all of a sudden, just like that. So if anybody else is having the same problem, or if you test it out, can you let me know in the comments below? Why can't Google and Apple just get along? Anyway, moving on to tip number 5, dictation. This is a major accessibility feature alert. Rather than type all the time, you can just talk to text on Mac. First, you're gonna make sure you've enabled the dictation feature. So for this, you're gonna head to your system preferences, then you're gonna select keyboard. Click on the dictation tab, simply toggle it on from here. Now, here you're gonna follow the on-screen prompts to enable dictation. And by the way, you can adjust your language and shortcut preferences here too, as well as your mic. Now all you have to do is hit the shortcut key, which is F5, unless you've just set it to something else. And now everything you say will be dictated for you, period. Remember, just like on iPhone or any talk to text, you're going to need to verbalize certain grammar aspects like commas and periods, period. It does a pretty good job off the bat, but you should go back through your text and adjust any errors as needed. All right, before we move on to tip number 6, if you're liking this video so far, please remember to give the video a like and also consider subscribing to my channel for more content just like this. And speaking of content like this, if you want even more Mac tips and tricks, just let me know in the comments below and I will make more lists for you. All right, tip number 6 is to bulk rename files. Oh boy, this is a major time saver indeed. So let's say you've just transferred a bunch of terribly named files over and you want to quickly organize and rename things. From Finder, simply select all the files that you want to rename. You're going to right click and select rename. From this pop-up, you can choose whether or not you want to replace the text, add text, or reformat the name. So as an example, if you choose replace text, you're gonna choose what text you want to find and then what you want it to be replaced with. If you choose add text, you can choose the text you'd like to add to the file name and whether or not you want it added before or at the end of the current file name. And then if you choose format, you can rename the entire file completely. So you could number your files here as an example. And then that way, instead of random files, you'd actually have them organized per number for you. Mac tip number 7 is to quickly convert images. Yes, you can quickly convert a PNG to a JPEG or vice versa in a matter of clicks. So from the image you want to convert, right click on it and then hover over the quick actions option. Here, you're going to have a convert image option. Click on that. And then in this pop-up, you're gonna have the option to convert the file to either JPEG, PNG, or HEIF. And here you can also adjust the image size as well. Then just hit convert, and it's instantly converted for you without even having to open that file. But wait, there's more. You can also quickly make a PDF file, which you might have noticed already, but you can do this with one or select multiple photos. Right click, hover over quick actions, and this time select create PDF. A PDF will automatically be created for you. So if you open that, you're gonna have a preview of all the images you selected in PDF format. Pretty neat. All right, tip number 8 is trackpad gestures. So, okay, I'm lumping a few of my favorite trackpad gestures into one tip for you. You're welcome. But in all seriousness, there are a few handy trackpad gestures that I set up anytime I'm setting up a new Mac. So first, to access those trackpad settings, you're going to head to your system preferences and then click on trackpad. Here, you're going to have 3 tabs at the top: point and click, scroll and zoom, and more gestures. In the point and click tab, I like to have tap to click toggled on. All of these trackpad recommendations are just that. My own recommendations and preferences. You may have your own too, and that's just fine. But anyway, I like to tap to click when you're on trackpad because then you don't have to actually like push down on the trackpad to click. You can just tap as the name suggests. So next, over in the scroll and zoom tab, one of the first things I do when setting up a new Mac is to toggle off the natural direction scroll. I don't know why, but it drives me nuts and it actually feels backwards to me. And in fact, not natural when it's toggled on. So with it off, when you scroll down, the page moves up, which to me is actually more natural because I'm scrolling down so that page should go up. Am I making any sense here? Anyway, there are some other settings in the More Gestures tab you might also want to play around with and really discover what works for you based on your preferences here. All right, this brings us to tip number 9, hot corners. Now, much like some of these trackpad gestures, hot corners are one of the first things I do when setting up a Mac. I love hot corners. Some might say I'm obsessed, and I think everybody should be using hot corners. To set up hot corners, you'll once again start in System Preferences, and this time head to Mission Control. From here, in the bottom left, select the Hot Corners option. Here, you can set all four corners of your screen to trigger a different response when you move your mouse there. So for me, as an example, I can pull up a new note when I move my mouse to the bottom left corner of my screen, and I can quickly put my display to sleep when I move my mouse to the bottom right of my screen, and so on. There are lots of hot corner options for you to choose from, so again, I'd encourage you to dig around in here and then set the actions that work best for your workflow. Like, I love having quick access to Mission Control in my hot corners with one flick of the mouse. I can see all my open apps and windows at once in one go. And we have made it to tip number 10. If you are on a Mac that supports Touch ID, you can actually enable more than one fingerprint, just like you can on iPhone. Again, we'll start in System Preferences for this one, but from here we'll click on Touch ID. Then select Fingerprint. Here you'll follow all the prompts to place your finger on the fingerprint scanner, just like you're familiar with when you're setting this up to unlock your iPhone. I believe you can add 3 fingerprints to Mac, but don't quote me on that. So those are my favorite Mac tips and tricks for 2022. And I've actually got links to other Mac tips and keyboard shortcuts below as well, so you're gonna wanna check those out. Remember, if you want even more specific Mac tips, just comment below and let me know and I'll make a video for you. I swear, I'll do it. So those are my picks for 10 Mac tips you should know. Now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite macOS tips and tricks and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Mac tips. Thanks for watching. See you next time.